called He's Just Not That Into You. Basically, what it teaches you is to let go of your fear of rejection. This book really helped me because we constantly make excuses and we try to deflect the truth that maybe we're just not right for something or we're not right for that person. You cannot be right for every single job, every single person, every single situation in your life.
When I was younger, I wanted to stop dancing just because I didn't want kids to have an extra excuse to make fun of me. And it's funny now that all these kids that made fun of me congratulate me and text me and call me and say I'm doing such a good job while they're watching me on TV.
Really hard time finding who I was as a dancer, and I recognized that as soon as I stopped caring what other people thought about me, I truly became who I was as a dancer.
One of the biggest things that I struggle with, going into a room, trying to say something and not being heard. I always want to make people great all the time and make people happy, and when I say something and I'm not heard what I want to say, or I'm not taken seriously, then it kind of takes me back to when I was young.
Growing up, there were a lot of obstacles in my life. Moving to America, learning a new language, seeing my parents struggle financially. It's tough because when you're motivated by the fear of losing, fear of staying broke for the rest of your life, there is a whole new passion that is born. Not until lately that I actually had a whole new revelation about dance. I love dance now because of what it does to me, how it makes me feel, and the opportunity that it creates for me to change the world.
When my parents got divorced, I had a really hard time with it. My relationship with my father kind of dwindled away. And since I didn't really have a relationship with him, I never felt as if I was enough. But my mom taking me to dance helped me get through that and helped me gain the confidence, and I was able to rekindle my relationship with my dad.
The things that I had to sacrifice to be where I am now is moving away from my family at a very young age and not really experiencing living with my parents and fully understand the love that they have for me. When I look back at it, I wouldn't really change anything because I think a situation like that is really shaping you, who you are, and make you stronger.
When I was a kid, dance and music would be my escape. As an early child in a broken home, I found ways to distract myself. When I was a teenager, I injured myself and I wasn't able to dance for a while, and I lost my way to escape, so I found a different way. Wrong crowd, lots of mistakes. I rebelled against everything. When I was 18, I looked around me at the world that I was in and I knew that I wasn't that person. Through all of the mistakes and all of the rebelling, my mom was that person that never let go, that loved me constantly, even though she had no idea how to fix me. If it wasn't for my mom and it wasn't for dance, I would not be here.
Cause I'm a little